I'd like to just take a few minutes and talk to you about how I imagine healthcare being delivered over the next 5 to 10 years. And for those of you who've been to see a physician in the last year, I would bet that when you went in to see them, that there was a piece of paper in front of them and they had a pen and they were writing down information. And you've always wondered sort of what's in that chart. And in fact, isn't that my information? And I think as we think about healthcare delivery in the 21st century, that is exactly the right premise, and that what we need to do is to bring healthcare delivery services into the age of consumerism. So I wanted to take the next few minutes to start to talk about how that might happen. So the first thing that has to be true is that there have to be digital tools that are available for everyone in the healthcare delivery system. So that means not just physicians and nurses and other allied health professionals, but also patients and consumers as they become active participants in their own health and healthcare decision making. What you see here is a set of tools that are at least a starter set to make that vision a reality. So the first thing is that clearly doctors and nurses have to transition from using pen or a piece of paper if we're going to use the digital infrastructure to change the way we deliver services. The electronic medical record is that core tool, and when you go into your physician's office in the future, you should fully expect them, in addition to interacting with you, to be using that tool to document what's happening related to your care. This is why the president came to the Cleveland Clinic. Our organization uses electronic medical records in all of our facilities, and it allows us to coordinate the care from one facility to the next. The second tool, then, are tools for patients. And the internet is with us everywhere we go today, and we need to take advantage of that from a healthcare point of view. And the goal is to make sure that you have access to your healthcare information when you need it. So the second tool is called generically the personal health record, and it does exactly that. It gives you access to the exact same information that your physician or nurse is using when they are caring for you and making decisions. The next tool are really tools for all physicians that might be involved in your care. So remember, as decision makers, you will decide who's part of your healthcare team, and they may be from one organization or another, but that is the best combination of clinicians in order to deliver care to you. And what you really need to know is that they have all the information they need to make the best possible decisions related to your care. So this tool connects one doctor to another, no matter what organization they're related to. The third piece is to then start thinking about services beyond just information services that could be provided in the digital age. And what you're seeing here is a web-based service that allows any patient anywhere. We now deliver this service in 60 countries across the world and every state in the United States at this point, where a patient who needs the intellectual advice and experience of a skilled physician that might be located at the Cleveland Clinic and who happens to be either 1,500 miles or 8,000 miles away from the Cleveland Clinic can do just that without leaving the comfort of their home. So they can go on the web, they can put in their primary diagnosis, the system will ask them a series of questions. If need be, they will express mail some material to us, and when all of that is done, we can then render the opinion to that person and then have them review it and then interact with them no matter where they are. And then the last piece is to start thinking about chronic diseases and where that's going to take us. You know, 75% of all healthcare dollars in this country are really spent on about 12 disorders. And those are very common disorders. They're hypertension, diabetes, asthma, heart-related diseases. And those problems are with those patients every day. And historically, we have managed those by asking the patient to get up and come down to the physician's office and check in, and do that once a quarter or every 6 months, whatever it takes, when in fact, most of what's happening in that interaction could take place from anywhere if the proper digital tools are available to both the physician and the patient. So this tool that's called My Monitoring does exactly that. It allows a person who has high blood pressure to have a digital device in their home to be able to collect that information and then make it available to their care provider no matter where they are. And then the final thing that I would say is that in order to connect everyone to everyone, that's a scale that's sort of larger than the focus that the Cleveland Clinic could bring to it. And so we've begun doing work now with global infrastructures that are capable of making the connections between every hospital, every physician, and theoretically every American. And so over the last 18 months, we've worked with Google and Microsoft to affect a couple of those programs. So those are the tools that will be required in the digital age. And I thought I would end the talk now by trying to take all those tools, put them together, and have you experience what healthcare delivery can look like in the 21st century. So let's start with a patient who's in Arizona, who in fact has been given a diagnosis by their local physician there and has recommended a treatment plan. That patient decided that they wanted a second opinion and that the expert that they wanted to work with was in fact at the Cleveland Clinic. So without leaving their home, they were able to go on the web, put in that information about their primary diagnosis, and then send a series of electrons, if you will, to the Cleveland Clinic, where a physician has the ability to review that information just as if the patient were sitting in their office and make their recommendation into that electronic medical record system that we use every day, and then return to the patient their professional opinion about what they should do. Now, in this case, the patient, in fact, has a serious disorder and is considering coming to the Cleveland Clinic. But before they ever leave home, we want to make sure that they are putting together the complete healthcare team that's going to care for them over a long period of time. The odds are they're not going to move from Arizona to Cleveland, and especially not today. And we suspect that they will want to have providers actively engaged in their care while they're in Cleveland, but also actively engaged in their care when they return home. So how can they make that happen? Well, they can go out to a service that is now in production. We did this pilot with Google about 14 months ago, and they can create a Google Health account. And what it does is it allows them to grab the information that's in digital form in their local community, about which I know very little here in Cleveland, and they can pull that information out of their local pharmacy, their local hospital, their local laboratory, and put it into an account that the consumer controls. Now that they have that information in digital form, they can do something with it. And the action they would like to take is to get that information in front of the physician who might care for them if they decide to come to Cleveland before ever leaving their home. So in that case, they go into their Google Health account, they select the Cleveland Clinic, and they are able to gather that information and push it electronically over to the physicians who are going to see them when they arrive. The important part here is it's all digital. It becomes part of their permanent record at the Cleveland Clinic, and we can start making some decisions about the kind of care that they're going to need on that first day when they arrive, so it's completely coordinated and we're not running around because we found some surprises on the first day that we weren't aware of. Now, that's about as much as we can do digitally. If that patient decides they actually want to come, in this case for a surgical procedure, to the Cleveland Clinic, eventually they are going to have to physically come to the Cleveland Clinic, and so they'll have to get on a plane and make their way here. But once they arrive, we can complete the loop because our physicians are using that electronic medical record as they care for the patient. And every transaction that we're recording can then be made available to their local physician, so they are following the care from each and every day back in Arizona. Because remember, that physician is the one who's going to care for the patient over the long haul. Now, after we have completed the procedures, we can make all of the information from the care that's been delivered available to that patient through a tool that's called MyChart. To draw this out a little bit, we decided to send the patient to Florida to recuperate. While they're in Florida, they needed to provide some ongoing information to their physicians back at the Cleveland Clinic. And so what you see here is that remote monitoring capability that I told you about. So blood pressure cuffs, glucometers for diabetics, peak flow meters for asthmatics, pulse oximeters for those patients for heart failure are all portable digital devices available today. And so that patient can go anywhere, collect the information, and transmit it back to their physician, who can then give them ongoing advice if needed. Now, eventually, the patient will make their way back home. And the difference now in this model is when they arrive at home, several things have happened. The first thing is they are traveling with all of their information available immediately to them from the Cleveland Clinic. The second thing is that we really have put the focus around the patient instead of around the care provider. So now that patient can take the information from the Cleveland Clinic, the information gathered from those monitoring tools, and make it available back to their physician in their local home community who's going to care for them over the long haul. So the sum of this story is if we take all of that information, if we stay focused on the patient, we can design a healthcare delivery system that truly puts the patient first and connects the information to the care providers that are required to deliver the best care. In summary, what we will be able to do is transition our healthcare delivery system from a provider-oriented system to a consumer-oriented system. Second, we'll be able to empower the individual patient and more likely consumers trying to keep from becoming ill with the tools and the information they need to do just that. And then the last thing we can do is fundamentally transform the healthcare delivery system so that we deliver the care that's necessary, where we need to deliver it, and when the consumer needs it. Thank you very much.